You told me I could change you, change you. Everybody know my name when I come through. Don't nobody screaming like you. I was having visions with you. Doing things, switching lanes in the Beamer with you. Then swimming in deep water, save me from my sorrow. Swimming in deep, just some pieces I need. So why can I get that for free?
What's up YouTube, it's your girl Taisha Lachey, and I'm back with another freaking video. Specifically, I'm back with another day in the life of a nail tech, as I should, okay? And I want to thank y'all for clicking on this video, as you should, okay? Because you're part of the family. All you have to do to become a part of the family is subscribe. That's it. Well, you could like and comment too and share with your mama and your grandmama if you want, but stick around. It's only gonna get better from here. And let's get into this video. So I have, it is 8:45 and I have a client coming at 9. And I'm just gonna show you how I set up for said client. I'm not going to show you how I disinfect and everything because I showed you that in the last day in life of a nail tech video. But as I was learning, I noticed that one of my holdups when my clients come is that I'm still trying to pull things out and set things up when they get here, and it should already be done. I also have a few packages that we're gonna open because in my last video I told y'all that I needed to like reorganize my nail polishes, and I showed you guys my gel polish color cart thing, and I had one young lady tell me that she finds it easier for her and for the clients to use swatch sticks. So I think that's what's in this one. I ordered me some swatch sticks. I did have those before, but I found that they were hard for me to store. But I have command strips that I can use and kind of like set them up behind me and then just pull like that. So I got that. And then I also got some top coat. I got the IBD top coat. They finally had some in stock for me to get. So I'm going to show you that stuff. First, I'm going to show you how I set up my table and how I set up my sink. So we'll open these afterwards. I have a little bit of top coat left that I can use on this client. And she's getting a fill, so I don't need the swatch sticks right now. She's a regular also. She's one of the people that's more comfortable with me filming. So yeah, that's what we're doing. I don't have much time to set up, so let's go ahead and do that. I keep towels over here and I just sit them out. I sit one out on my desk. Unfold one and just sit it on my desk like this or on my table like this, and I put the other one right over here on my little stand, like right here. So that's its home. And then I'm going to go ahead and add an implements pack. These are pre-made. I showed you that in the other video. I sit that here. I also go ahead and pull out my powder. I always clean out my dapping dish. Always. I do not reuse monomer or anything like that. I pick which brush I'm going to use for the day. If it's a shorter set, I normally gravitate toward this one. I go with this one for smaller sets because the width is smaller, so that's the one I'm gonna use. As far as my drill goes, I take out any bits that are on here and put them back in its case. If it was used on the skin, I put it in some Barbicide, and then my drill bit like this that has my coarse bits on it, I completely take that off. I do put the bit inside because you should always have a bit in this barrel. That's why when you buy them, they have one that's like, doesn't have this, it's just the pole. But you always wanna have a bit in your barrel. And then I just sit it here and leave it like this because I want my client to see that I'm putting a new bit on here. That I'm not using the same one that somebody else used. And what I also like to do, since this is in hand's reach, I do not pull these out until I'm ready for them because otherwise it'll be in my way. I also charged my drill bit yesterday. I mean my drill yesterday, so I'm not gonna charge it now. I don't wanna overcharge it. I have the Nat Plus drill. She's worked pretty well for me. I've had no issues. So I'm gonna leave her here. And that's pretty much all I do over here. And also, if you use these, make sure you spray them, like disinfect them with Lysol. I spray mine after every client and I let it air dry. And I try not to use this to dust my table off. Sometimes I do, because you know that's what we do. But I try not to dust my table off with this. But this is clean. In my last video, someone asked me what lamp I use. So this is the... this. I don't know how to pronounce it. If I can find the link on Amazon, I will. Let me see if I can pull it up on Amazon. Okay, so it is the, I don't know if it's gonna really be able to focus on this, but it's the Lumacrissy LED nail dryer lamp. Heavy duty, it's like the ones that they use in the nail supply stores. I love this, it dries faster and everything. So this is the favorite, this is my favorite lamp that I've owned so far, and I've bought several. So I keep that over here. I don't always keep it plugged in, but it's plugged in right now. That's about it. She's getting ready to come on in. I do also take temperatures. I got this off of Amazon and I leave this over here at my station. So they have to wash their hands. They sit down, I take their temperature. And that's it for over here. I don't put monomer in my dish till I'm ready to use it because I want them to see that I'm using fresh monomer. And now I'm gonna go set up my sink. As far as the sink goes, I have this one specific area here that has been disinfected, wiped down, all of that. So I have this bin here. This has my little things in it. I always take one out and sit it on the edge of the bucket like that, and I sit it right there with the lid. So when I'm done doing the acrylic and I tell them to go wash their hands, I say grab the one on the edge of the bucket, wash your hands, scrub thoroughly, throw it in the white bin so that it can be, I toss these, I don't reuse them. Some people soak them in Barberside. And then I have paper towels here, which I need to refill, but I have pre-pulled paper towels here. And I leave these here like this and you just grab and go, okay? Because I didn't really want people reaching and touching this. I wanted to, you know, get rid of that. So this is a little setup for the sink, the little soap and everything. And everything has been disinfected and wiped down. So I'm gonna go ahead and do some nails and I'm gonna put that in here. We'll see what we come up with. She doesn't know what color, but she does know she wants decals. So yeah, let's go do some nails.
Say time heals, so quit blowing up my phone, cause you're not mine still. We will never be again, you're in denial. Oh, you'd always make me go to sleep so angry. Got all of these girls calling you baby. Why you always put the blame on me? Like I'm the reason that we ended in catastrophe. What about what you put me through? All the crying over you. I run away cause I'm a track star. I'm sweet advice until I'm so far away. I cannot lie, leaving it so hard. But I know that it is way better than to stay. So stop telling all your boys that you are mine still.
So my client is gone, and now we are going to open these boxes and start on the swatches. I need to go ahead and get that done. Try to get this out of the way. This is the top coat. I ordered mine off of Amazon, but most local nail supply stores will have it. So what I'm gonna do is, I just recently started doing colored acrylic sets, so I have a bunch of new like colored acrylics. So I'm gonna also swatch those. But y'all, what am I supposed to do with this? I really love this. Well, I'll hold on to it for now. We're gonna start with polish. This is my polish drawer. This is what it's looking like right now. Completely full, completely full. And then I have D&D polishes back here. So I'm gonna start with a brand. I'm gonna pick out one full brand and then sort it by color. So let's do that first.
Sometimes I wish you knew, but I disguise the truth. I say I'm happy, but I'm still stuck on earth. Does your mind play this game too? Think about me and you. I guess I'll just pretend until it all makes sense. See you face to face, I'm thinking about the days we used to be. But I can't make a scene. But I can't make it seem. See you face to face, I'm thinking about the days we used to be. But I can't make it seem. But I can't make it seem.
Done with the polishes. I just finished my last set of these, and I'll show you how I kind of like organized it. I need to go to Dollar Tree and get some more of the hoops because I am also going to do the acrylic today. I got my command strips from out of my, from underneath my sink, and this is where I have it hanging. So easy access, I've got two on the middle one, one here and one here. So that's what we got going on. And now the drawer is hella organized. Yeah, she looks good. So I'm happy with this. So to the girl, to the young lady who suggested this and do it by brand, thank you very much. Okay, period, sis. Next, I'm going to work on this drawer, but I'm going to go eat first and then I'll come back and do this drawer. Yeah. That Dollar Tree didn't have it either. So I'm just gonna have to do them and store them somewhere until I can get another ring. So I'm headed home. Okay, y'all. So my last client of the day just rescheduled for tomorrow. So we're gonna carry this over into tomorrow. I am about to swatch my acrylics now. So I guess we can work on that while I wait. I remembered that I had old swatches of polishes that I don't even have anymore. So I do have one ring left. So I'm gonna use that on the acrylic. I'm gonna do the same thing with my acrylics. I'm gonna break them down by brand and swatch them and write the name on it.
Look at her. Look at the mama, man. Look at her. That ain't my girl. That's my nigga. Catch me out on Ocean Drive with her. Catch me in the whip riding with her. Hey, sipping something, bumping big, hypnotized with her. Pray you get that job in Tampa. That's only 4 hours away. Take a car, take a plane, baby, whichever is faster. Oh,
okay. I'm kind of glad that my last client didn't show up because it gave me a chance to really get a lot organized. So y'all know that I'm swatching my acrylics right now. And it's much later in the evening, but this is what I've gotten done so far. All of them are named and organized by brand. I'm learning that I don't necessarily care for the Mia Secrets colored palette of colored acrylics, but they'll do. And then I realized that I have a lot of custom mixes. So I'm gonna swatch these for y'all so y'all can like physically see them. I didn't like swatch all the other ones. I let y'all watch me do a couple of the Mia Secret ones and then I went ahead and just finished. But I have 2, 4, 6, I have 7 custom colors here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna print out one of my Crown Nail Bar labels that I have for like my press-ons because it's all the same thing. And I'm gonna put that on top and then I'm going to make a name and label to go here so it can be all cute and whatnot and be incognito, because I had a bunch of like these little containers, my labels here. You can't really tell on camera. It is now 10:43. I'm not tired. And as far as like my decals and stickers and stuff go, I put them in this little binder. I stole it from my mom. I think you can get them from like Target and stuff, but I have them in these little pockets and it's all separated. So the first page is designer, the second page is butterflies, and then I have 2 pages of snake skin. I've got flames, I've got Halloween, and I've also got letters in one of these, and my clients always mess them up, so I have to go through and fix them. And then as far as like my loose glitters and stuff, I keep all of that at the bottom. Let me go do this. And like I said, I'll screen record on my phone so that you can see what I'm doing. Good morning. So I thought my appointment was today at 9 a.m. It's not until 1:30. So it's 11 o'clock. And I wanted to show y'all the swatches that I did. I also showed you guys how I created my labels. So I didn't really talk during that portion. I just screen recorded my screen. So I made them on Canva and I'm printing them on pink label stickers and I'm just going to put them right here. So remember, these are my custom colors that I've made, just out of pigments. So this one is lemon drop. This one is sweetie. This one is, I don't remember. This one has blue butterflies in it. I don't remember the name that I picked for this one. I think it was blue butterfly. I literally think it was blue butterfly. Okay, here we have clouded It looks a little muggy right now because it's dried and there's no top coat, but she's super cute. And then we have Stupid Cupid. And if you do not get that reference, you're too young to be here. So here's Stupid Cupid. And then I have Maymay. And I named this one Maymay because I made this custom mix for my friend when I did her nails for Valentine's Day. So we have Maymay. And we have Dorothy. It's not red, it's more like a magenta, but it reminds me of Dorothy's slippers. So we have Dorothy here. This color is hella sparkly and cute. I love this one. It came out really pretty. But yeah, those are the custom mixes that I have right now. I plan on making more, but this is what I have so far.
Will I see you at the show tonight?
Hey.
2:30, baby, won't you meet me by the beam? Too early, baby, later, you can show me things. You know what it is when I visit Windy City, she throwing me kisses.
Hey.
2:30, baby, won't you meet me by the beam? Too early, baby, later, you can show me things. You know what it is when I visit Windy City, she throwing me kisses.
If you don't know, I do own a press-on business, a press-on nail business, and I actually have an order that I need to fulfill. So I'm gonna work on that and I'll show you guys that process.
Will I see you at the show tonight?
Hey.
So I just finished the set. First, we need to package the order, which is over here.
She said, baby,
and she is nice and taped up. I try to do it as neatly as possible so that it's still cute. And then your Hey Queen, your Crown Nail Bar packages arrive, and then the Crown Nail Bar logo here. So I'm gonna go ahead and run this to the post office. I'm not gonna show y'all that because who cares. By the end of the time that I finished doing nails. I will need to replenish everything. I do need to like refill my bottle, so I'm going to refill my alcohol bottle, which isn't that empty. Usually the really empty stuff, like my acetone, and for sure by Modiber. And this is the monomer that I use. It is EMA, not MMA. I have also emptied out my trash. I usually do that after every session of the day because I don't want that monomer smell to linger. I'm going to also replenish my paper towels. I'm gonna go finish this and then I'm actually, since I have some time, I'm gonna do my nails. And then that'll be the end of the video, so I'll be right back. So that was indeed the end of the video because I am not even at my house anymore. That's really all that I do. That was about a day and a half worth of work. Sometimes they're a little bit longer, sometimes they're a little bit shorter, but this was about a day and a half worth of work. It's Crown Nail Bar, the salon, and then Crown Nail Bar, the website. That's what I work on majority of the day. So I hope that you guys enjoy. Let me know what you think. I've left some interactive pieces in here. So answer some of the questions in the bottom if you feel like it. And I will see you guys in the next one. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on your post notifications so that you're notified every time that I upload. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.